Hey YouTube, what's going on? Lionheart here, and on today's video, I want to talk about the new fishing system in Genshin Impact, including how it works, all the fishing locations that I found, and some tips that may help you along the way. If this video is helpful, be sure to subscribe and enable alerts for future content. And thanks! Okay, welcome to the most addicting and fun thing you never knew you would love in Genshin Impact. Fishing. Here's our agenda for the video. We'll do a fishing overview, then we'll talk about the regional associations and what you need to do to get to all of them, how to get your recipes for bait, the different fishing locations, how to catch more fish at each location, and other useful tips that may help you. Feel free to watch everything or skip ahead to the content you prefer using the table of contents. All right, let's start with our fishing overview. Fishing in Genshin Impact is very similar to fishing in Stardew Valley, or so I'm told. I've never actually played Stardew Valley. Your goal is to catch fish by using the right bait and then playing a mini game where you must keep a marker inside a tension zone that moves around by increasing or releasing tension on your marker using a one button input. Progress toward catching your fish will only increase while your marker is inside the tension zone, and you will lose progress whenever the marker falls outside that zone. If your progress reaches zero, you may lose the fish, so try not to let that happen. Occasionally, fish may try to escape while you are catching them, and you'll know when this happens because the tension gauge will turn orange and your control will become super sensitive. Like, if you press it, it will go farther than you expect. If you let go, it will drop more than you expect. Okay? This is a temporary state and does not mean you are about to lose your fish, which is what I thought was happening the first time it occurred to me. You just need to do your best to hang on and see if you can reel that fish in. And likely, if you're getting into this orange state, it's probably a very valuable fish, so it's even more important for you to really try your best. Speaking of value, why go fishing at all? Well, it's fun. So who doesn't like to have fun while playing video games, right? But the main reason is actually to obtain free weapons, such as the Catch, which is a new 4-star polearm that provides energy recharge and increases the crit rate and damage on your elemental burst. You can also earn new furnishings for housing. There's only one new furnishing right now. It's a large pond, but you need that pond to place your ornamental fish in inside of your housing. And ornamental fish are these special fish that you'll catch in the overworld, and we'll talk more about that. And then lastly, there's better fishing rods that you can also buy with regional bonuses. And these are more of a luxury item for those who want them, right? It'll make fishing in each region easier, but you actually have to turn in quite a lot of fish to get them. Who knows? MiHoYo will probably add more rewards in the future, but we'll have to see. To start fishing, you need to return to Mondstadt and speak with Catherine. She's the person you turn in your dailies to, and she's at every adventurer's guild across the whole place. But you need to go specifically to Mondstadt and speak with her there. She'll give you a new quest, and you will meet your very first regional association contact. There are three in total, one in Mondstadt, one in Liyue, and one in Inazuma. Once you meet the first one, you can find all the others by zooming in on the map and looking for their store symbol, which looks like a stand with a fish on it, a fishing stand, I guess. The Liyue Regional Association representative is at the far southeast docks in Liyue, and the Inazuma one is northwest of Inazuma City on Narukami Island. Make sure during the tutorial with the Mondstadt one, which you'll meet because the tutorial makes you go there, make sure that you catch all the fish you can and don't worry about bait. I know when I did this, I had like 10 of each bait and I was like feeling like I needed to hoard. You don't need to hoard. You're going to be able to make a lot of bait really soon, and you need to catch fish in order to unlock the bait. So just don't hoard. Just use all your bait and catch every fish you possibly can at that location. All right. Follow the quest line until it ends, and you should be good. And by that point, you should have enough fish to exchange for bait recipes. At least, if not all the bait recipes, at least one or two of them. So what you're going to do is you're going to return to the Mondstadt Fishing Association rep, and you're going to trade him for all the bait recipes you can. I think they cost like 3 of those like goldfish looking things per bait recipe. So get all the, you're going to need all the recipes, get all of them. If there's some you can't get the ones you can, learn them, craft up enough bait, and then go out fish and go back to him to get the ones you couldn't buy, okay? Now, the place you go to craft bait is the alchemy stand where you would normally craft upgrade materials. You need to carry an ample quantity. An ample is like, in my mind, at least 50, right? An ample quantity of all the different baits, because the fish at most of the locations on the world are procedurally generated. So you don't actually know what you're going to find. There are some locations where that's not true. Like there's one location where there's only one kind of fish that appears there. But some of these locations, it's procedurally generated. So you may have like 5 of one fish and 2 of another, or 3-1-2-1, right? Like random combinations. So you just want to be well stocked on all the different baits. I think that part is important, okay? I've marked here on the map in each region all of the fishing locations that I've found. And I've also cross-referenced this with miHoYo's official Teyvat interactive map, which will lead you to all these same locations. And as far as I can tell, these are the only locations for fishing in the world. So I'll add a link if you don't know how to get to the official Teyvat interactive map. I'll add a link to that in the description below, so you can go there and use that, or you can just pause this video and look at these areas that I've recorded. And I strongly recommend that you actually use this new fishing hook pin yourself on your own map to make it easier for you to find the different spots, okay? And you can create your own fishing route and just go through and do lots and lots of fishing, okay? If you made it this far, well, thank you. And also let me share what I feel is the most important tip about fishing with you, okay? Most people are gonna go to a fishing spot, they're going to fish, they're going to leave, and they're not going to get the full amount of fish that they could have gotten out of that spot, thinking that they cleared it because no more fish respawn. Fish spawn in 2 different cycles, during the day and during the night. Now, this is different from a respawn, okay? The fishing point has a respawn timer on it. We don't know what it is because it's only been a day since this has been out, but I think the rumor from like beta testing was it was like 72 hours. So similar to crystals, right? Mining crystals. So 72 hours from collection, by the way, but we don't know for sure. That's just the rumor. So I can tell you right now, none of my fishing has respawned since I've collected it, and it's been almost 12 hours. But basically the fishing spawn itself has 2 like groupings of fish, right? If you go to the fishing spawn point during the day, you'll see 1 grouping. If you go to the fishing spawn point at night, you'll see a different grouping. So make sure every single fishing spot that you visit, you clear it out, and then you immediately cycle to the opposite time of the day. If you're fishing there during the day, go to night. If you're fishing there at night, go to the day. So that way you do not miss out on any fish, and you collect the maximum amount you can on your route. And I think you'll probably just do a route where you just go through all the continents, right? There's no reason not to, especially when you need lots of fish right now. So that is the most important tip I can give you, okay? If some people are gonna tell you it only works if there's ripples in the water, nonsense. I've seen no ripples in the water, switch to night, and boom, there were fish magically appeared, okay? There's no telltale sign for this. Sometimes the ripples do remain, but sometimes they don't. So just be safe. Every fishing point, just catch it, and then whatever time you catch it, switch to the opposite time, and just do that at every single fishing point, okay? You'll thank me. You'll thank me later. Okay. So, and then again, no one seems to really know the respawn time on these points. It's definitely longer than 12 hours. Probably no longer than 72 hours after collection. We'll figure that out pretty soon. And my guess is it's the 72-hour one. A few more tips that might help you. If you see a fish jumping in and out of the water, that is probably an ornamental fish. Ornamental fish are the kind that you can put on display in your housing. So yeah, don't mess up catching it. Also, if you throw your line too close to a fish, you're going to spook them, and you'll notice that they will refuse any bait for a short duration. Like, you can tell when this is happening because they'll create an unusual number of bubbles in the water and start like going crazy. But some of the bigger ones, like the puffer fishes, they don't actually move that much, so you'll need to look for the bubbles. You may spook them and think they're ignoring your bait and get frustrated, and that's just not the case. Lastly, if you're having trouble with tension, if you're having trouble catching fish because your line is breaking or you're just like dancing around a lot, here's a trick that I think actually works pretty well. Do your best to keep an eye on the tension zone and its movement rather than your marker. I think a lot of players have a habit of looking at the marker and watching the marker kind of dance back and forth to make sure that they're staying inside the bounds of the tension zone. But actually, if you stare at the tension zone and ignore your marker, maybe you're watching your marker with your peripherals, but you're really just staring at the tension zone, you'll notice its movement more quickly. And so if the tension zone starts to move right, you're gonna press your button, right? And if it starts to move to the left, you're gonna release the button. And this will make following along a lot easier, as you'll see the movement earlier by just focusing on the zone and not your marker. I know a few of you are like laughing about this last tip, but like, I promise you, it's going to help. And for someone out there, it's going to be like the tip that makes it so much easier and enjoyable. All right, and that's it. It's a pretty simple system, guys. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments below. You can also join me live for more gameplay on my Twitch channel at twitch.tv/lionheart. Hope to see you there. If this video was helpful, be sure to like and leave a comment below. Each patch, I release new videos about characters and other updates that may help you in the journey ahead. If that sounds interesting, don't forget to subscribe and enable alerts. All right, thanks for your time, and I'll see you on the next Genshin Impact video.